We're moving on to Game Pass or gameplay.
Oh boy.
And now, to summarize what this is for all you new listeners and for you existing listeners, I know you're excited about this one.
Hell yeah.
Every month, at the very beginning of the month, we spin a wheel, and that wheel shoots out a Game Pass game. It's all the games in Game Pass are included, except for games that Caleb and I have played, and games that have, like, reiterative versions
basically
of them.
Basically just, yeah, reiterative sports titles. Like, we're not playing, you know, Madden 16 isn't in there.
Yeah, Madden 16 is not in there. The most recent Madden is. So if that's something you guys are interested in, this is where that's going to be. And then at the end of every month, we're going to give our review on the game that was picked last month, and then we'll spin the wheel again. And that's what's happening today, because this is our first podcast of June.
Yeah, it's a little complicated, but yeah, the first episode of May, we spun the wheel, we got a game. And now, since it's the first episode of June, we are going to review that game and tell you whether you should Game Pass on it, you know, not play it, or game play it, which means you should play it.
And what was that game, Caleb? It was indeed DayZ, the zombie survival, I guess, kind of hybrid game that is based on a mod from Arma 2.
Is it Arma 2 or Arma 3?
It was Arma 2 first, because Arma 3 wasn't out yet.
Oh, okay.
Then Arma 3 came out and they upgraded the mod, and then it came and became its own game.
Gotcha. Jaren, the fucking historian over here. How's it feel having a fucking big brain weighing you down like that, Jaren?
Dude, I don't even have the history degree either. That's you.
Yeah, I have two.
So, Caleb, I'm going to let you start. What did you think of our time with DayZ?
I can go ahead and spoil, you know, whether you should game pass or game play on it ahead of time, because it kind of is the premise for what I'm going to say. I think that DayZ is a good game to play from Game Pass. Now, do I think you should play it forever? No, but Jaren and I hopped into it, and like Jaren said, it's a, you know, third-person perspective, but you can go into first-person. It's a survival, traditional hardcore survival game. You have your food meter, your cold meter, or your temperature, I guess you would say, your thirst, you know, all this shit. You can bleed, and you have to patch yourself up if you're bleeding. You have a health icon, and it's a really survival-based game with, you know, zombies that are kind of fast wandering around the world. And it's just a huge map that you get dropped into in, like, fucking Russia or some shit. There's trees and mountains, and there's a beach and a coast, kind of like a PUBG map, essentially. And you're there, and there's a bunch of buildings and rundown towns and resources. And the premise of DayZ is that there are other survivors in these servers. And so you can run into each other and either make friends and alliances or, you know, fucking murder them. And so you wander around, you got to collect resources. You may, you know, you kind of want to build yourself up, maybe form some sort of settlement, and just survive because of the zombies. So Jaren and I hopped into a server together, and it doesn't spawn you. You don't really play, from what we could find, you don't really play co-op. It drops each of you in a random spot in the server where you spawn, unless you go to, like, specific servers, but I'll tell you more about that later. So Jaren and I kind of spent our time in co-op. Our goal, as it were, in these games, where you kind of create your own goal, is you try to, we just try to find each other, which, dude, harder than you'd think on this huge ass map. And so you go into these buildings and you just loot a bunch of, you know, shit. And it's actually, Jaren, I'll throw out there, in the base game, there's two ways to play this game. You can play a normal server, like the normal game, or you can find servers made by the community and other people that are, have, like, you know, seven times the loot or a certain spawn location or whatever. And those games are way better. Okay, I'm gonna throw that out there. You want to play in the servers with more loot. If you play the regular game, there's no loot everywhere. People steal everything. It's all gone. It takes forever to respawn. It's the worst. But if you play a game with a bunch of loot, you get a gun. You can actually fight some zombies. And Jaren and I had a hell of a time in DayZ, just wandering around doing all sorts of shit. You can fish. It's a little obtuse, the menu systems are. So you kind of gotta, it's meant for PC. So on console, you're gonna have a little bit of a hard time figuring out how to craft different things and what to do. And it's a very obtuse way. You're gonna maybe have to look up some things to do, but it's overall, if you can get past the initial kind of menu system and you have someone to play with, it's a good time trying to find each other and dick around. There's zombies. I found, like, I one story is, like, I ran up on a dude, like, I was looting these houses, I opened a door, there was a man there, I was like, shit, and I closed the door, and then, you know, I was scared, I was tepid, I ran away, then I ran back to him and I opened the door and I was like, hey friend, you know, like, hey buddy. And he was looking at me, and then he was like, he tried shooting me, or he hit me or something. And I was like, motherfucker! And then I just beat the shit out of that man. And he was dead, and I took his stuff, and then I was the boy with the cool helmet and the gun. And I chased the man with an empty gun down, like, a neighborhood, and he was running away, and he was running these houses, and he was trying to shoot at me, but his gun was empty, he couldn't reload it. Beat him to death, dude, hid in the kitchen, and then just waited, and I was, like, looting stuff around, you know? And I heard the door open, I was like, the fuck was that, Jared? And then you turn around and this man is like, either it's the same dude or it's his friend, like looting his corpse. And he doesn't know I'm there, dude. I sneak around the corner. I blast his ass away with a shotgun. It's just a good time. You know, it's just shenanigans. But anyway, what do you have to say about this game? I've rambled on long enough.
Yeah, I kind of feel pretty similar to how you feel about it. Definitely, you got to play the modded versions of the servers. Because when we played the original one to start, where we just got dropped in a world, Caleb and I wandered around for probably like 45 minutes and found absolutely nothing and then just starved and to death.
Yeah, the things that we had found places, like they had already been looted and the loot hadn't respawned.
Yeah.
But it was a good way to learn the game, I guess. Like you learn, I guess it's kind of a good way to learn how you die and like how that works in the game and kind of just fist fight some zombies. It's like a tutorial almost.
Yeah, that's true. And in that sense, if that would have entirely just been the game, then like 100% we would have said don't play it. But
it's not the game.
Yeah, it's not the game. If you can easily hop into the modded servers and the achievements and everything work there and all that kind of stuff, the private servers. So there's really no downside not to play in those. If you hop in one of those with loot being times five and you actually manage to find your friends, you guys can actually have a pretty fun time in this game. Like, this game is janky to shit. It is super hard to understand and play. But once you figure out how to play it, it's an enjoyable experience.
You may be, if you're a bit more of a hardcore gamer, you'll be able to get into it better. If you're a very, very casual gamer, then I would actually recommend you probably pass on this. But again, if you're a more hardcore person and you have someone to play with, like Jaren and I found each other at a military base and we went in the tents and like we were able to get a bunch of actual weapons, like with suppressors and scopes and a bunch of med kits. And I was able to stint Jaren's leg and he couldn't get up and he was bleeding out. And I had to find some rags and some sticks and make a stint and stint his dumb ass up. And it's crazy. It basically, the game becomes PUBG with zombies. Once you get, you know, established enough with enough food and weapons and you find a backpack and you have like some combat armor and a helmet, it's just PUBG with zombies on a huge ass map. You know, it's a good time.
Remember when I shot that man accidentally?
Oh, yeah. Was it accidental?
Yeah. So what happened was, we'll give you a quick story from the game. Four zombies jumped over a wall when Caleb was standing next to Dara. That's my sister. So I shot the four zombies to keep them safe, obviously. And then a man jumped over the wall, followed by three zombies. So I just assumed he was also a zombie. So I shot him in the head and then I shot the three zombies behind him. And then I was like, oh God, that was a man. I didn't mean to shoot that random innocent man. And I felt kind of bad about it. And then from that point on, since I had already killed, I then proceeded to just murder every person that we saw because it was in my nature at that point and I felt the bloodlust.
Jared felt the bloodlust and he sent me a video of him like going to like some storage units and like one's open and there's like, you know, 8-9 zombies in there. And Jaren just looks in and he's like, what the fuck? And then he just unloads on these zombies. Bah, 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 and they're all dead. And then he's like, whew. And then he hears, and you're like, the fuck was that cough? And then he opens the adjacent storage unit and there's just a person sitting there like crouched in fear. Jaren just mows him down. It was horrifying. It just obliterated him. He saved him from the zombie horde that would have killed him, and then he just obliterated him.
So I'm going to give this game a play. I feel like it's worth the memories that you can make with your friends. If you're playing this game by yourself, maybe pass on it unless you're really big into these kind of survival games. But if you've got like a group of friends that you can meet up with and actually go through the journey of finding and getting all this stuff and playing on the modded servers, I'm going to give this game a play. And I'm going to give it 3 innocent survivors shot out of 5.
Okay, that's a decent review. And I kind of echo Jaren where I'm like, yeah, if you have friends, you should play it unless, you know, like, yeah, you're really into this game. And I would say you should make your goal trying to find each other. First of all, go into a modded server with, you know, the more loot and shit. And just make your objective be like, my friend and I are going to try to meet up. And I recommend doing that if you can. If you get a gun and you fire off, because directions are really hard in that game, the map's huge. You can just fire a shot and be like, did you hear that? And then if they say no, then they're not close. And if they're like, yep, then they can, you know, you guys can find each other. That's how Jaren and I ended up finding each other. And so I recommend trying to find each other. And once you do, you know, maybe dick around until one of you or both of you dies and then see if you want to do anything else in the game. But yeah, definitely give it a shot. And I give it 7 dead people that Jaren murdered out of 13.
And that is the end of our DayZ review. The XBlock podcast as a whole gives the game a play because Caleb and I both gave it a play.
Yeah, and that, you know, just play it for like a couple hours with a friend. Good time.
Yeah, it's worth it. It's free in Game Pass. Yes. If you got it, might as well give it a shot.
And that is the premise of Game Pass or gameplay. All these games, you can just download and play anytime you want. It's whether you should just try to play it for a couple hours. And just, you know, last thing, Jaren and I got all the achievements, both of us. So, you know, GG.
Yep, that makes us 3 for 4, I think, in games for getting all the achievements.
Yeah, yeah, we're pretty hardcore, Jaren. I'm not going
to
brag.
And now we will spin the wheel, Caleb, to find out what our game for June will be, an already packed month where we have to fit in a game to play.
I'm really fucking scared. Because if it's... What, Jaren, what if it's Yakuza? What if it's Dragon Quest?
I hope to God it's not.
All right, spin the wheel, Jaren.
All right, here we go.
Spin that wheel.
Ooh. Ah. Ooh, my God. Yeah, baby. Yeah.
People are gonna think we lied.
What?
People are going to think like that this isn't true. Should I spin it again?
Well, is it true or is it not true?
Well, people are going to think it's not true because it's Psychonauts.
Nah. Right? You know what, Jaren? Leave this. Just leave this in and then they'll know that it's true. We're doing Psychonauts, I guess. Yeah, just leave this whole discussion in and then people will know. Yeah. All right.
So- I guess our game is Psychonauts for June.
People are going to think we lie.
Yeah, people are going to think we totally just were like, we should play Psychonauts. And then we went and on purpose spun it in the wheel.
Jaren has an actual randomizer. Jaren, you know that meme that's like, phony, you're a phony. That's what people are yelling at.
Yeah, and between, so where Psychonauts is, just to give you some context, is between Final Fantasy VII, the remade version that isn't the PlayStation one.
Yeah, the HD one or whatever.
And Kingdom of Hearts 3.
Kingdom Hearts 3, you mean?
Yeah.
What a fucking dodge.
So we split the two most dangerous of games that we probably didn't want to play, and we landed with Psychonauts.
Nailed the field goal. Fucking close one.
And I guess that is the end of Game Pass or gameplay. So if you want to hear our Psychonauts review, come back for the first week of July.
It seems so staged. I'm excited, man. I'm actually am, because I mean, now I guess I get to try this game, which I wasn't gonna do, but I guess now I have to for the podcast.
Yep. So there you go. We were both talking about playing it earlier on in this podcast, and Caleb was like, well, Jared will play it and I won't have to. Turns out we both have to play it.
GG, God, you nailed it.
And like I said, that is the end of Game Pass or gameplay.